Hi, I am working on the second part of my game, Defenders of Undercalm, and I am trying out some changes in the controls, the player interface, that I am going to use in this game, that is going to be a little bit different from what I did in the first game. One of the things that I will be changing is the control for how to walk around in the game. In the first part of the game, I mainly used the system where you click on the point where you want to walk to. That particular system works fine when you can walk straight towards that point. If you have to go around some things to get there, it's not as good. For that to work, I would have to invent a pathfinding system, which would be very nice, but perhaps more work than I want to do right now. So instead I have come up with the idea that you can direct the characters walking by moving the mouse around, and the character will follow the mouse pointer. I think that will be the standard model I will be using in this game. One thing that makes this system workable is that I have started using color-coded maps to mark out where you have walkable areas and where your character will be stopped if it tries to walk out of this area. I'm planning to make a separate video for the color map. Anyway, between the color mapping and the follow the pointer walking system, it will now be possible to walk around in a room and go in front of and behind certain objects, which I hope will give a more natural feeling to the game. So, we have a stand mode and a walk mode. And I have also added a look mode. When your character is in stand move and you move the pointer over an area where there is something to look closer at, the game will go into look mode and the mouse pointer will change icon to a look icon pointer image. If it is a smaller object that is lookable, you might need to stand rather close to it to be able to look at it. If it is a large object, you can look at it from anywhere in the room. If you left click at a lookable object when the look pointer icon is active, you will get some information about that object. When you are in the stand mode, you can also activate an interact mode. You do that by right-clicking. If you move the pointer over an area where there is something that you can interact with, the pointer will change to an interact pointer image. And if you left click on that object in that state, you will get some interaction. That could be that you pick up the object in question. If you have picked up an object, you can put that object into the inventory by right clicking. In the first part of Defenders of Undercalm, I had a bar that was both a toolbar and a bar for the inventory. For part 2, I will split this up into two separate bars, one for the tools and one for the inventory. Similar to the first game, the bars will generally not be seen, but you can make them visible by moving the mouse pointer to the top of the game screen. To use interact, you will generally need to be standing close to the object that you are going to interact with. Similar to the first part of the game, I will in this second part be using word balloons for the dialogue. I have made some technical improvements on the word balloons that might not be all that obvious to the player, but makes it a lot easier to write the dialogue. Part of the improvement is that the program can set the position of the balloons, which is very useful when you have characters walking around in a room and can have dialogue at different positions that cannot be handled manually by the programmer. This system works fairly well, but it is not always completely clear which person is speaking from the placement of the balloon alone. So I have added small portraits of the person speaking to the balloon so that the player should not be in a situation to wonder which character it is that is speaking at the moment. Well, that was some of the things that I am trying to introduce in this second part of the game. I hope that it has been at least a little bit enjoyable to look into what goes into working with a game like this. And, well, that will be all for this time. See you hopefully in a later video. And for now, bye.